broadcasting live from the headquarters club.
It's hot.
Hey, what's going on? What's up, everybody? This is your boy, Mr. His Hop, coming at you once again from the headquarters. This is His Hop Radio, Las Vegas. We're not far from the strip, but we outshine every light on that strip and in Vegas because we shine a light of Christ, y'all. That's what we love to do. We started off as a club hip hop ministry back in 2012, and now we're on the radio network. We're podcasting. And we're doing this thing. And so it is my pleasure, actually, to let y'all know that I'm not rocking solo today, y'all. You know, I have an amazing co-host that I want to bring online. I want to let y'all know that she's been rocking with me. You know, she's kind of new to the podcast thing. So, everyone, let's say what's up to Desiree. Desiree, what's going on with you?
What's up? How y'all doing today? We're so glad y'all tuning in. What's up, His Hop Nation?
Hey, I see something a little new about you today. I see that you done hooked it up.
Look, we chopped it off, baby. We done chopped this thing off. But you know what? I'm rocking with it because I feel like in this season, I cut my hair, but I also had to cut other things out of my life that were hindering me too, right? So this is a refresh, the outside appearance and the inside, okay? So sometimes you gotta chop it off, okay?
Come on, we gotta do that sometimes. You know, we have to have the courage to, and that's something the Lord has been dealing with me. Actually, this morning, the Lord has been dealing with me with this issue. There's people sometimes that are in your life that you have to have the courage to chop off, right? Because they can bring you into a lukewarm state. You know what I mean? They could hinder your walk with God. So sometimes it's either people or it's things. You know what I mean? It could be pursuing a career, pleasure, anything that will try to master you. You know what I'm saying? It's like you got to, like the Lord was telling me that this morning. Now look at you. Come on. Well, see, this wasn't even planned. This was just.
What you say? But God knows, and He also knows what we need in the season and the time that we need it. I think a lot of us, and I'm speaking to you online, some of us have to chop some things off. Some of us have to cut some things back and put them in their proper perspective and place, right? And some stuff we just need to go all together. Right? Because it's hindering us in our relationship and our walk with Christ, and also it's hindering us from growing into the person that He's called us to be. So if you're holding on to something, whether it's unforgiveness, whether it's a sexual immoral spirit, whether it's a lying tongue, whether it's a hurt and pain that you've experienced and somebody has inflicted upon you, you know, or hurt and pain that you've inflicted upon somebody else. Like, today is the day of salvation. Today is the day to let it go and chop that thing off. And some stuff, you know, especially like with marriages, children, jobs, and things, we just have to put it in its proper perspective, right? Doesn't mean that God says, I'm going to take it away. But if you try to put it above Him, He's going to take that thing away from you. And we definitely don't want that to happen, right? And we just want to put it in alignment with God's perfect will and not His permissive will. But anyways, I'm not gonna preach today, though.
I tell you what, man, somebody needed to hear that. And that was a truth bomb right there. You hear the explosion? I'm gonna have to get an explosion sound effect, you know, whenever you hit those truth bombs on the podcast. Oh, man. Hey, that ministered to me. Somebody needed to hear that. I needed to hear that, you know. Say God is good, and I just want to say that we are living so close to the return of Jesus, man. Like, we gotta lay aside every weight, like every distraction. We really gotta be focused in this season. I believe we have an assignment, we have something to do, and then we're gonna be getting out of here soon, you know. And so that's the thing. Okay, all right, well, today we have a guest. This will be the first guest that we're actually interviewing together, first artist ministry.
We have guests, I need to make a theme song so I can sing it before the guests come on.
Come
I'm
on.
Be working on it.
Come on, come on. Theme song, come on. Desiree. National, did I mention she's a national recording artist as well? And also, real quick, we have to vote. You've been nominated, right? Tell us about that. Where can we go to vote for you and your little situation there?
Yes, the Gospel Choice Awards that will be in Atlanta, Georgia on this year has nominated myself, Desiree, and the Flatline Movement is the group that we're a part of that produced the song. We Need Your Love has been nominated for the Contemporary Christian Artist of the Year and the Female Artist of the Year. So we need y'all to go vote. Listen, if I can, we're gonna put that link below in the comment section somewhere in on this video. We're gonna put it in there. Y'all can vote. We need all the votes we can get.
Come on. Support. Definitely, we're gonna be voting and we're gonna be riding for you over here on the Hip Hop Nation. So
thank you so much.
All right, now we're gonna talk about my brother John E. Ross, man. He's been rocking with Hip Hop Nation for a while. He's been a great supporter, probably one of our top supporters. He's consistent for one thing. What you see is what you get. I've never known him to switch up, you know what I mean? You know, sometimes you can get into a situation with a person and they switch up on you. You know, I've never had that with my brother, Apostle John E. Ross. He has a Let's Talk to the Lord radio network. He's actually on a Hip Hop radio network as well. If you download the app, you will see him there. He's got his hands in a lot of different things, and he's been on here before. He's had a couple of songs, a couple of releases that we've showcased and gave him his flowers, you know, here on the network. And he's got a brand new release that we're going to talk about, and we're going to jump into a couple of other ones that he's had on the show. And so he's doing a lot, now I can't name everything. So without any further delay, we're going to bring the brother on here. He's going to let y'all know what the Lord has been doing in his life. So let's give a Hip Hop Radio welcome to Apostle John E. Ross.
What's up? What's up?
How you doing, Apostle?
What's up, Brother Sam?
Welcome to the podcast, my brother.
Man, I am glad to be back with Hip Hop Nation once again.
We are so glad to have you, Apostle. We are excited to hear about your new release and what God is doing in your life and in your ministry. So are we going to go ahead and play a video real quick?
Yeah, we're going to play a video. It's the release this has been out a couple of years, I believe. It's called Lord Give Me Another Chance, and just that title alone is really powerful. So John, tell us about this song. You go ahead and introduce it as we go ahead and just get into it.
Lord Give Me Another Chance is featuring Dr. Sean E. Scales and the late Tamara Lloyd. We released this EP a couple of years ago. It is available in all digital stores and all digital outlets. Lord, give me another chance.
All right, y'all, let's do this thing right here on the Hip Hop Radio Network.
You are listening to the Light of Las Vegas. This is the Hip Hop Radio Show.
Trying to do what's right. but end up doing wrong.
You see,
Satan is trying to take a hold of my life. I keep on fighting and fighting, and it seems I'm losing the fight. But Lord, I'm silly from my heart. I think it's time for a brand new start. So, oh Lord, give me another chance. Now come on and help me sing it right now. Oh Lord. I mean this from my heart. I promise I won't sin no more.
I won't sin no more.
Yeah. Creating me a better heart. Ever knew a great spirit in me. Have thy word in my heart. Sin against me. Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord. I really made up my mind. I made it this time. So come with me, come with me. From day to day, I'm willing to another chance.
I feel a key change. Come on, let's go. Woo!
I mean this from my heart.
I really mean this from the bottom of my heart. Lord, give me another chance. Johnny Ross. I saw Desiree, I saw you vibing to that.
Baby, he said, oh Lord, please, baby. He got me.
Well, you know, one thing I do. Go ahead.
Come on.
One thing about that song I do want to point out, like you really got to get to a place in God to promise that I'm not going to sin no more.
Yes, Lord.
Because that's a big promise. Like that's a big promise to give. Now, are you talking about this specific sin? You know what I mean? That maybe you're struggling with, and like, Lord, I ain't going to sin no more. Are you saying you ain't going to sin, period? No, like, you just going to live a perfect life before the Lord. Like, what? Well, what is he saying in that song, brother?
Well, we should all strive for perfection, but specifically, I was talking about that plotting and planning sin. You know how you go and you want to set somebody up, or you just like kind of like what King David did with Bathsheba, that intentional lying sin. We're going to lay it down on the altar, and Lord, if you just forgive me and give me another chance, I won't do it again.
Amen. Okay. I can vibe with that.
That's also like when we talk about when Paul talks about in the Bible that the thorn died. If that thorn be there, but we have to make a conscious choice and just not to willingly go into that sin. You know what I'm saying?
That's
like, because we have the temptation still there. We have that thorn still there. But I fall every time we're presented with that sin, you know, because we're not perfect.
Yeah,
but we have to strive to be more like Christ, which is what you're saying in the next song. I got you.
Yeah.
I got you, brother. That's good.
Yes. Amen. Come on. Yeah, he came out.
And you know, that's where God's going to judge us at. When it comes judgment day, he knows that we are flesh. We are created flesh. We are flesh beings. So we're not going to be perfect like exactly like him. We can strive to be like him, but he's going to be looking at that intention. He's going to look at the iniquity in the sin. He's going to look directly at your heart, and he's going to be able to decipher what you were plotting, planning, and lying about. Was this intentional or was it unintentional? And that's where judgment is coming.
Come on. I feel the fear of God already. Amen. Lord, don't let me sin no more. Come on. Woo. I know that's right.
I don't want to. I can't do it.
Amen. Amen. And usually when you get to that point, that sin don't beat you upside the head so much. Woo. Like you tired of getting beat down. You know?
Look, especially if we say that he is our Lord and Savior. That Lord part, that means that he regulates. He's in control. Now, he ain't Lord and Savior. You might not be saved, my friend. And we're going to talk about We're going to do some confessing and get it together, because he has to be Lord and Savior. That's in conjunction together.
Come on.
But that's where that sin no more come from. Him being Lord and Savior. Knowing that even in your flesh, that he's in control, even when you do fall, even when you do slip up, even, you know, when you do make mistakes or poor decisions. Baby, who are you running to? To your friends, to social media, to a job? I mean, who are you running to? Is he really Lord? Are you running to him first to talk about it? Or are you going to everything else? Anyway,
hallelujah. All right,
come on. That's good. That's some good stuff. Good stuff right there. All right, we got you in the hot seat now, Apostle John. So tell us everything that you're involved with. Maybe not everything, but the main things you're involved in, you know, a little bit about your background, and then we'll get into your next song that you got currently out. But tell us a little bit about what you got going over there.
All right, we'll keep it to the short version, because this is just a 30-minute podcast. So we will keep it to a short version of what's been going on with me. But basically, I am the creator and host of the Let's Talk to the Lord gospel radio talk show and Let's Talk to the Lord Radio International. They work hand in hand, and we thank God, because out of rebirth, that was one of my first assignments, was to begin that radio ministry, and the Lord has grown that ministry tremendously. The Lord Lord have mercy, I done forgot the name of my podcast. Lord Jesus, let's talk to the Lord. Thank you, gospel. Amen. Radio talk show, and it is available for you to hear. We are live, or pre-recorded live, on His Hop Radio every Sunday, and I believe it is at 2 o'clock Central, 12 o'clock Pacific time we're on.
Yes.
If you want to download copies, you can go to speaker.com, www.speaker.com. Don't forget the apostrophe and let's. We are on iHeartRadio. You can search us out on the iHeartRadio app. We are on Roku, and the radio station is now on Roku. You used to have to go to the MyTuner application to get to the radio station. Now you can go to Roku and just put in Let's Talk to the Lord Radio. Bam, we're there. We're on several radio stations throughout the country. The Lord is blessing that ministry. We are almost at 500 episodes, getting ready to end season 8, getting ready to start season 9. And the Lord has blessed that podcast. Souls have come to the Lord. People have been encouraged. And that's our main radio ministry. Let's talk to the Lord.
Come on, come on. And you know what? That's nothing to sneeze at. I have to say, rocking with you over the years, Apostle John, I've seen some great influential guests that you have talked to on your show. Like, you know, some big names, as well as you talk to the independent artists as well. You know, you don't judge anybody. You know what I'm saying? So, and I've met some people through you. You've introduced me to some people as well. So it's been a pleasure.
Yes, sir. Let's talk to the Lord. We're going to have Desiree on so we can feature Desiree on Let's Talk to the Lord.
I'm telling you. Yes, yes.
Absolutely, absolutely. I would love to be a part. It sounds like it's just a God-driven show. Baby, I look for Christ in anything. Okay, so if Christ is there, and we talk. We the title is "Let's Talk to the Lord." Woo, baby, let's talk to him.
Come on, come on. No one better to talk to. Come on.
Yeah, that's the best one. You know, and so I love that that God has allowed you almost 9. Seasons of the podcast, which is and
almost
I pray that he gives you
500 Brother Sam. 500. We're coming up on 500.
Yeah. Wow,
that's beautiful. Now listen, let's get into this song. Now I'm excited because I love music and I love ministry in music. So can we go ahead and jump into it, Sam?
Yeah This song is called Awesome God. This is his latest release, and we know that God is awesome. And myself personally, I've been able to, you know, if I can't sit down and just get into God's presence and worship and just reminisce on how great God is and stuff like that, it doesn't get on my playlist. But I'm gonna tell you that this song takes you there. So Apostle, tell us about Awesome God.
Awesome God featuring Sheree from Los Angeles, California, and Mitchell Johnson and Rehoboth out of Charlotte, North Carolina. We are in pre-orders right now as we speak. You can go to Amazon and pre-order the album. Apple Music is moving just a little bit slow. I'm not sure why Apple Music is taking so long to get this up in the store for pre-orders, but we are in pre-orders. If you want to pre-order, you can go to Amazon right now to pre-order. We are releasing next week, March 28th. We will be released in all digital stores worldwide. Awesome God, written by Apostle John E. Ross, featuring Sheree and Mitchell Johnson and Rehoboth.
You are listening to the Light of Las Vegas. This is the His Hop Radio Show.
You're my provider.
Come on.
Hey! Glory.
We're talking about an awesome God. You hear me? And even just the words awesome God, but how you describe the awesome God, you know, and use his name. Baby, I love it. I'm gonna go ahead and pre-order is what I'm about to do. And then the lady that's leading, baby, she felt that in her soul.
Yes, Lord.
Come on.
Yes, Lord. The spirit, I feel. Woo. Okay.
Come on.
All right. I'm done for the day.
Come on. It takes you right there. And man, it just reminds me, you know, it reminds me how inadequate I am, because first of all, you said that he is our defender. He is our like, how awesome has he been in my life? I mean, the Lord came into my life when I was 15 years old, y'all, when I was young. And I'm like, I'm nowhere near I need to be. It's like, God, you've been so good and you've poured so much into our relationship. Like, I should be further along. Like, that brings, you know, brings tears to my eyes, because God has been so good. He saved me from so many situations. You know what I mean? He saved me from getting fired from my job. He saved me from accidents and gunshots and different things like that and bad relationships. Like, God, you are an awesome God, and it just makes me want to come up on the type of son or the way I have been treating him. You know what I mean? So that's what the song does for me. So what was your purpose? What was the vision behind writing this song, Apostle?
Awesome God is a song of worship and praise and adoration to our God for who He is. Adoration is a strong emotion and regard for God. So this song is a worship song, and is unique because it's a worship song for a choir. It can be sung by anyone, but its essence was written for choirs and ensembles. So Kingdom, I want the listeners who love God to worship God as they are listening. Worship God for who He is and all He has done. And if you have a request or a need, please articulate that need to God as the song is playing. And I agree in prayer with you that every need will be met in Yeshua Jesus' mighty name. And I decree and declare, you will be blessed. Hallelujah. Our God is awesome. Words cannot describe His awesomeness, nor the monstrosity of His capacity. His very essence is infinite, meaning limitless or endless in space. It is impossible to measure or calculate the infinite mercies of God. His sovereignty, meaning His supreme power and authority, creator of all things and everything. He's almighty. He's omnipotent because He is complete power over everything. He is omniscient, meaning all seeing and all knowing, and He's omnipresent, meaning everywhere at the same time. He's eternal, which means He exists forever. Our God is immortal, living, and never dies.
Come on. Hallelujah. Man, right. That's a praise right there, man. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. You're so amazing and so awesome. And here's the thing, man. Here's the thing. And as you were saying that, I was just thinking about all the people who don't know Him and they don't know how awesome He is. Like, we got to get past ourselves. Like, we think we awesome. You know what I mean? We think we're all that. You know what I'm saying? We think we deserve the spotlight. But once we humble ourselves, and we really realize and recognize this awesome and great mighty God that we serve, if you don't serve Him, the God that you got to reckon with one day, I'd rather serve Him now.
All right,
man. Woo. That's good. That's powerful.
Man, I tell you, I had to fight to get this song recorded and complete. This song was a song I was actually wanting to do when I recorded Lord Give Me Another Chance, and the Lord brought me a Tamra. So I thought, okay, Tamra, but the Lord said, do Lord Give Me Another Chance. And I was like, well, I want to do Awesome God. And so I said, I know what I'm doing. I'm gonna go ahead and do Lord Give Me Another Chance. And then I'm gonna go back and ask Tamra to produce Awesome God. Well, Tamra passed away. And so the exact day that LaShawn Pace Rhodes passed away, just hours between each other, she passed away. And so I was stuck thinking, okay, Lord, how am I going to be able to bring this together? And it took several more years. But I tell you, when we were in the timing of God, being led by God, He brought me to the lead and He brought me to the background. And I just believe that folks are just going to be blessed once they purchase this EP.
Amen. Amen. I agree with you. I agree with you. Apostle, man, you've been consistent. You've been faithful. I just want to say that I appreciate your ministry. I appreciate your spirit and your heart and your love for the Lord. You know what I mean? That's the main thing, man. And it's refreshing and it's inspiring. You know, you're helping a lot of people, and a lot of people are going to get to heaven because of the work you're doing now, because of your faithfulness. So I just wanted to give you your flowers, my brother.
Thank you. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about.
Amen. Amen. So right now we're going to ask you, how can people contact you? First of all, obviously, you're letting everyone know that you write music. You are a writer. So is that a service that you offer? If someone wanted you to write them a song, is that something that they can do? And then if we wanted to write either a rap song or my sister Desiree, she's more of a worship. She does some hip hop too, but you know, she's kind of like our rhythm and praise artist. What style do you write, or do you just write for choirs and stuff like that?
Man, I write by God's anointing. The Holy Spirit just downloads. And when I'm writing for like a project, I go to God in prayer and say, okay, Lord, I need some material for this project. So I need, and I don't want to just put out anything that comes from John. I want to release what comes from God.
Come on.
So I ask the Lord specifically when I'm writing for that, and then I have pen, paper, and recording device ready, expecting, receiving, ears inclined to hear from the Lord. So the Lord has just blessed me basically to write in just about all the genres. We can write for choirs, we can write for hip hop, we can write for groups, we can write church music, we can write, just about in contemporary gospel, and we have some more good stuff on the horizon. So keep your ears open. So if we're gonna pray that the Lord will give us grace, and that sometime toward the end of this year another new EP will be on the horizon.
Amen.
All right. That's good. Listen, sir, I'm ready. I don't know about y'all. If y'all not ready, I'm gonna need y'all to hurry up and get ready, okay? And make sure y'all are following Apostle John E. Ross and his group to make sure y'all stay up to date to what they have going on, what events they're doing, as well as making sure y'all go purchase their music, stream their music, the old songs as well as the new songs that are coming out. Because God is on the move. I believe God is doing a new thing and a great thing with his people. He's just revealing himself day by day to us. Yeah. And we just have to see he is. And how to, even if we don't have the closest relationship with God or Christ, how to stay surrounded by people that do have a close relationship to God.
Yeah. Come on.
So that's good. I'm just excited. I'm excited.
And to get in touch with me, you can either go to the website, Let's Talk to the Lord Radio .international. There is a place where you can leave me a message, or you can email me at letstalktothelord@yahoo.com. You can email me at johnross544@gmail.com. You can follow me on x.com at Ross Apostle, or head on over to Facebook, John Ross. We have pages for Working on Let's Talk to the Lord. We have pages for Let's Talk to the Lord. We have pages for Apostle John E. Ross. We have a page for John E. Ross, all on Facebook. So if you want to reach out to me, message me at any of those locations, and I will be back in touch with you. If you want to collaborate, want to have me come out, speak, preach, teach, whatever you need, I am a servant of the Lord.
Come on now, that's a true servant of God right there. When you're just willing to do whatever God has put in front of you to do. You know what I mean? I know pastors and apostles, they'll clean the bathroom. You know what I'm saying? They'll do whatever God has called you to do. So that's, you know, the Bible says the greatest will be the servant of all. So
Amen,
Apostle. I appreciate that. And do you have a Instagram? I didn't hear you mention Instagram.
No, I am not on Instagram yet. I'm on Getter.com, but I am not on Instagram, not yet. But pray for us. Maybe we'll get there.
Amen. I never heard of that. What is Getter? Do you say Getter?
Getter.com is more of a kind of a conservative Christian kind of political website. And so we have quite a few followers over there on Getter.com.
Okay. All right. Oh, man, I'm going to have to check that out.
That is like a for Christians.
Say that again. You cut out a little bit.
Is that like a LinkedIn type of vibe?
It's more of like a conservative political for those that are conservative and have conservative values.
Gotcha. Okay, that sounds good. All right, well, before we close out this segment, we actually have one more song we're going to get into, and this song will get you moving. It's got a nice little vibe on it, and I believe you could say this is almost like your theme song, right? Isn't this song kind of what you always say at the end of every... Yeah, you say that at the end of every show, don't you? Or that's kind of like ours is, you know... it's not about us. It's all about the Christ in us. That's how we always close out our show. But ain't that how you close out your show? Remember thou, Creator?
No, but we do talk about it during the episodes. But I close out everything with until next time. May the Lord richly bless you and keep you living your lives at the foot of the cross under a open heaven. In Yeshua's mighty name we pray. Amen.
Come on. All right, so go ahead and introduce our last song, Remember Thou, Creator. What inspired you to go ahead and get this song out, and who's actually in it?
Remember Now Thy Creator is featuring King David the Vessel, Doctrine, and a new duo. It is more of a, I would say more of a rap kind of hip hop kind of vibe, and it was written actually for a choir, and so we pray that the Lord is going to bless us and anoint us, be able to get that choir version out sometime before this year is out. But right now we have kind of the hip hop version of Remember Now Thy Creator. In the days of thy youth, while you're young, serve the Lord while you're young, give the Lord your life while you are young. Don't wait till you're old, or wait till something drastic or dramatic or horrible happens to you to get you to surrender. But surrender to God while he is calling you.
You are listening to the Light of Las Vegas. This is the His Hop Radio Show.
Hello, I am Minister John E. Ross. We'll be right back.
I'm not for the years from now. Thou should have no pleasure in this. This is starting while you're ill. This will soon it come. It's never too late. What's giving life today? Do you remember?
Now, thy creator, in the days of thy youth. Remember now, thy creator, in the days of thy youth.
By the evil days come night, for the years drop nigh, and thou shalt have no pleasure in pain. Jesus is calling while you're young, it's soon to come, it's never too late, but you're giving life today. Won't you remember?
Creator, in the days of thy youth, remember now thy creator, in the days of thy youth.
Christ on your side, you can make it. 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 Jesus is calling, here I'm calling you. Jesus is calling, Jesus is calling, Jesus is calling, here I'm calling you. Jesus is calling, say he's calling, Jesus is calling, here I'm calling you. Jesus is calling,
he's calling,
Jesus is calling, here I'm calling you.
Remember, he called from day one. Remember the times you had a stack of the guns. Remember the times where everything went wrong and you blamed everyone else with that same old song. You got old. You gotta call Jamaica. Don't let God become paper. Nobody's beyond redemption, man. Jesus can save you. Truth be told, he's a righteous savior. Look, homie, you gotta call it on your life. You heard me right. He chose you. You don't think he knows what's going on. He know you. Just like you, I was born from sin. Now I'm born again. And if you love me, then you'll find purpose again. Nobody's in this land. Cause God got a plan. Look, open your heart. If you down and out, God is all you got. He'll lift you up.
All right, all right. We are back. Desiree, what are your thoughts?
I said, Jesus is calling, baby. He's calling you. Y'all need to hear him calling, all right?
In the days of your youth, you know what I'm saying? Don't wait till you get old.
All right.
Because we don't know tomorrow's promise.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Oh man, I tell you what, I really enjoyed having you on, Apostle, and I just want to thank you for being a very, very vital part of the His High Network and coming on to the podcast with us today. It's been awesome, my brother.
Man, I appreciate you. It's good being back again. It is good meeting you, Desiree, and I appreciate you, Brother Sam, because I reached out to you and I felt the Lord saying, well, I was like, Lord, I don't know if he'll air us on his network or not. I don't know. And he said, well, reach out to him. And once I did, you received me and have been a very vital part and push for our radio ministry. So I definitely appreciate you, sir.
Amen, amen. To God be the glory. Yes, come on. Amen. Yeah. You know, Father tells us this is what we need to be doing. We need to be loving on each other, right? That's what Father tells us, man. If we had more love in the world, you know, a lot of drama would be eliminated. You know what I'm saying? Amen. All right, well, I'm going to just open the floor. If y'all have any final comments, you guys can do. It could be just something the Lord just put on your heart to say or whatever. And then after that, I'm going to go ahead and close us out on this segment. So, ladies first, you have any final comments, Ms. Desiree?
Listen, I just want y'all to be blessed. I really enjoyed your Apostle John Eros. I thank God just for him creating the things that he needs to come out of you for others to be able to see his righteousness through you. So I appreciate you coming on and sharing your ministry with the world. I appreciate you, Sam, as always. Thank you, my brother, for letting me come on to His Top Nation podcast and being able to spread the good news of Jesus Christ, because Jesus Lord is not going to change.
Amen.
And we Easter Sunday, Resurrection Sunday, and we just want the people to know that He shed His blood. He was tormented. He was beaten just for you, just for me, so that we can have a reconnection with God in an eternity with God, where we don't have to worry about mourning or weeping or crying, dealing with all the foolishness. But He came so that we can have life and life eternal, and that we don't have to die anymore once we accept His free salvation. It's free. You don't have to pay for it. You don't have to work for it. All right? So I just pray that y'all just make the choice of salvation today if you have not. And if you feel like you have gone so far away from God, or gotten away from His desire for your life and His perfect will for your life, it's okay to come back. It's time to come back. Time is running out. And we don't know if we're able to live for the next second. So make the right decision. Choose Jesus. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man, no one can come to the Father except. But He's waiting for.
Amen, amen. Apostle, any last words?
Amen. Again, awesome God. And she was bringing up that we're coming up on Holy Week. So during Holy Week, we will be releasing Awesome God, the EP, 7 tracks. You can go and pre-order right now at Amazon.com. And we should be in all digital stores. For the Apple users, we're on our way. Apple's kind of slow with the pre-orders, but we will be there at least by the release date on March the 28th. And we thank God, because this is a time of God showing His awesomeness, who allowed His only begotten Son to be born in this world to redeem us back to Him. And then unfortunately, He had to be cruelly treated. He had to be crucified to ratify our redemption back to God. But He came anyway, and He bled, He died, and He gave His life for you and for I. In fact, we have a Resurrection Part 3 episode that will be airing this week next Wednesday at 6 p.m. Central Time at www.kingdominfluencersbroadcast.com. Our special guest for that episode is Dr. Antoine Hutchins, Dr. Jeffrey P. Key, and Apostle Terry L.B., and we will be discussing this day, you will be with me in paradise. We're going to be talking about the thieves that were on each side of our Savior on the cross, and one repented and went with Him that day and was resurrected to heaven that day. or and when Jesus died on the cross that day, was left with to go. And then the other one, unfortunately, did not repent, and he had to face judgment. So that is the topic that we will be talking about. So please tune in for Resurrection episode on Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Talk Show.
Thank you, Apostle. We appreciate that. Yes, tune in. Check it out. Support our brother. Support our sister. We enjoyed this podcast. I'm happy to be back in the saddle, y'all. I'm happy with the people that are coming on here and my co-host as well. And just everyone. And my wife was on the last episode. So just keep us in prayer. And, you know, God has opened the door for us to go into the juvenile detention centers out here in Las Vegas. We want y'all to pray for us, because we get to introduce people like Apostle John Ross and Desiree. We get to introduce their music and to share these people out here on the front line. You know, these people out here who really have a heart to really see people changed, healed, delivered, and set free. And I'm glad that our sister Desiree had extended an invitation to anyone out there who has not received the Lord. If you don't know the Lord, if you're not walking with the Lord, I'm telling you, now is the day of salvation. Jesus came to save you, to save us. He has saved me. Just think about it. Just almost every facet of life, almost in every area of life, we need to be saved from something, right? Like, you think about it. If we're in traffic, that red light will save us from getting into an accident. If you're at work and you're cutting wood or something, the safety goggles and your safety gear will save a piece of wood from flying into your eye. You know what I'm saying? So the concept is that Jesus wants to save your soul from eternal punishment and damnation in the wrath of God. The Bible says we're all sinners. You might not hear this all the time. You might go to a church and they just fluff the gospel and they don't bring this point out. But the word of God says that we're all sinners, and the wages of sin is death. We're all headed to hell unless we reach out and accept the gift of salvation through, just like our sister Desiree said, the Lord, right? He's our Lord and Savior. That means we give him our lives. That means he is in charge, right? And he will save us. And so if you get anything else out of what we do, that's the main thing we want you to hear, is Jesus loves you and he wants to save you. And check us out, His Hop Nation. Go to our website, hishopnation.com. Download our app. It is available on all platforms. His Hop Radio. Once again, it's His Hop Radio. You get more godly content, and also use it as a tool to witness. If you know somebody who loves hip hop music or anything, they're into whatever, because we got more than just hip hop on this app. But if you know they need the Lord, tell them to download this app, and don't even tell them what it is. And trust me, they will get ministered to. It is a tool to evangelize. We're not here to entertain people. We're here to win souls. So in all platforms, His Hop Radio. And I'm going to close out like I always do, y'all. It's not about us. It's all about the Christ is in us. Yes, amen. Lord. God bless. And we will see y'all next time.
Bye.
Bye.